So today we will discuss the applications of BET adsorption isothermal. And although the theory is very important, but the outcome is most important, which you are getting out of the equations. And there are three very, very important calculations over here, and which you will use to calculate the surface area, or you may say this is the total surface area or the specific surface area of the adsorbent on the material in on which the adsorbate is going to adsorb. And all these two calculations about the surface area and the specific surface area, we will be using the monolayer adsorption capacity. So all these are dependent on the VM, and actually the value of VM you are getting from the BET isotherm. So first we will know the how to calculate the VM, that is called the monolayer adsorption capacity, and then we will be using this VM to calculate the total surface area and the specific surface area. So let this is the just the repetition of our first lecture. I'm not going to detail because this we have already discussed the equation. This is the BET adsorption isotherm, and this is the constant. Constant is given over here, that is called the BET adsorption constant or the equilibrium constant. And here V is the volume of the gas at a pressure P and T, and Vm is the volume of the gas adsorbed to form a monolayer, saturated monolayer per gram of the adsorbent, and simply you can call it the monolayer capacity. And this is actually very important over here. And these are the P over P naught is the simply P is the pressure of the gas, and P naught is the saturated pressure of the gas at temperature T, and the ratio between these two is the relative vapor pressure. So actually this I have already discussed with you in detail, but I am just repeating over here because we are going to use this equation to calculate the VM. And simply this is the straight line equation. First, this is the y-axis. You have to plot the this parameter on the y-axis. On the x-axis, this is P over P naught as written over here. And this is the intercept. 1 over Vm, and 1 over Vm is the intercept, and the unit of the intercept is C centimeter per cube, and it may be different, maybe the millimeter or the meter, it depends on what volume you are using to for the specific experiment. And this is the slope, and slope is given over here, the same. And the easiest way to calculate the Vm is as we have calculated before in the previous lecture. You just take the sum of the slope and intercept and divide by one. That will give you the value of the Vm. So if you want to learn more, so just watch the previous video in which we have already discussed in detail how Vm is equal to 1 over slope plus intercept. So let's move to our the topic of discussion today. So Vm you are getting from the slope and the intercept, and then this is the very simple formula for the surface area here, that will be equal to Vm, N, S, and V. All these are the constant, only this is the variable, which is the monolayer capacity. N is the Avogadro number, S is the adsorption cross-section area of adsorbing species, and let's suppose in case of the nitrogen gas, which is the adsorbate specifically for the BET adsorption isotherm, and its cross-section area is 0.162 nanometer square. And the V is the molar volume, this is also a standard 22.414 liter, and A, the small a over here, is the mass of the adsorbent. Actually, the difference between the surface area and the specific surface area or the BET surface area is, if you divide the mass of the department, this surface area become a specific surface area or the BET surface area. So there is only just the difference between these two surface area are given over here, and more appropriately we will be using the BET surface area, because when we will divide the mass of the adsorbent, that will actually give you the surface area of the adsorbent. And this calculation is very, very important. As I have said earlier, in the area of the nanotechnology or the nanomaterials, when you are synthesizing the nanomaterials, this surface area is very important. And this is the technique actually which is giving you the to calculate the surface area of the adsorbent. That means which material you have synthesized, you can calculate the surface area by using the BET adsorption isotherm, and this is the application of this isotherm. So this I have manually calculated. How you want to calculate? First, I will do the surface area over here, and where you call it this total surface area, and that formula is like this. Vm, the value of Vm is given over here, and this you have to calculate from this slope and the intercept, 1/1 slope plus intercept, and you are getting from the by plotting the graph between x and y axis. So this value you are getting from the graph. The rest of are the constant. N is the 6.02 exponent 23 molecules of the gas, nitrogen gas. S is the cross-section area of the nitrogen, and that is the 0.162 nanometer square, or you may convert into the meter square by using the conversion factor. I will explain over here later on. So this is the volume will remain the constant. This is the 22.414 liter or the decimeter cube. So I am just putting the value in this equation and using the unit cancellation method. And the units are over here are very, very important, because if you are not putting the accurate units, then you are not getting the correct value of the surface area. So the value are given over here. So here, if you have a keen look on the VM, actually the previous we study the unit, these are the 391.2 centimeter cube and per gram. So actually it is already given over here. This is the volume per gram of the adsorbent. So what we are going to calculate out of this VM, this will give you directly the value of the BET surface area. So because there is only difference between the surface area and the BET surface area is the to divide the weight or the gram of the adsorbent, and here it is already divided, so there is no need to separately divide with the formula to get the value of the BET surface area. So let's start with the calculation. Here the value is 391.2 centimeter cube per gram, and I want to convert all in the SI system. So actually to convert into the meter, 1 meter will be equal to 100 centimeter. And why I'm using this factor over here, because this is called the unit cancellation method. This centimeter cube is going to cancel out this centimeter cube, and you have to take the cube of this whole figures, 1 meter over 100 centimeter. So cube, that means 1 meter cube will be over 100 or 1 exponent 6 meter centimeter cube. So this centimeter cube will be canceled out with this centimeter cube, and meter is left. So we have done the right calculation with the VM. So the other one is the Avogadro numbers. This is there is the replacement of the unit over here. So second one is the Avogadro number, and Avogadro number is 6.02 exponent 23 as written over here. and this is the small s is here 0.162 nanometer square. So again you have to convert the nanometer to the meter, so 1 meter will be equal to exponent 9 nanometer, and you have to take the square of this whole unit. So that's why this nanometer square will be canceled out with the nanometer square, and 1 meter square is left. So we have rightly done the unit conversion with the small s. Now with the V, and V is the 22.414 decimeter cube or the liter. So you have to also use the conversion factor, which is 1 meter will be equal to 10 decimeter, and you have to take the cube of this one. So dm cube will be canceled out, dm cube, and meter cube will be left. So with this, you have also done rightly conversion factor with the V, and now just to calculate what is in the numerator and the denominator. So here, what is left? This was the 100 power 3, 100 cube. When you take 100 cube and move up, that will become exponent minus 6. And this is the, when you move up, this will be exponent minus 9, and square of exponent 9 will be exponent minus 18. And this is the same Avogadro number. Similarly, when you move up the 10, it will be 0.1. And when you take the cube of 0.1, it will be minus exponent minus 3. So this is a simple way. First, you just multiply the this whole figure and sum up all the minus 6, minus 18, and plus 23. That will be equal to minus 1, and all these like this. And in the denominator, there is 22.414. When you solve this one, and you will get the value of this 1702 meter square per gram. Again, if you have a look over here, this is the meter cube, this is the meter square. So the whole the unit on the numerator will be meter 5. So here in the denominator, this is the meter cube. So 3 will be canceled out with the 5, and 2 is left. So meter square is left, and gram is coming from the already from the VM. So this is the unit is giving you the information that meter square per gram, it is the BET surface area. And if it is not with the gram, so here the value you will be getting will be the just the surface area, and then you have to separately divide the weight of the adsorbent you are using to calculate the surface area. So this is the all about how you can calculate the surface area and the specific surface area by using the BET isotherm. And let's do with the exercise, and you will do at home. I am just explaining over here. This is the data. Data is the adsorption of nitrogen gas on the titanium dioxide. This is also one of the material, the nanomaterials we are synthesizing in our laboratory. And there are a lot of other nanomaterials the students are working on. In a similar way, you can calculate the surface area for any of the material you are synthesizing or developing or fabricating a new material. And then you can calculate the surface area by using this method. And this is the temperature is given. So it confirmed that it is the BET isotherm, because you are getting data from the BET isotherm. Also, you can verify when you plot the data, it will give you the state line that will also verify that this is the BET adsorption isotherm. So our target is to calculate the VM. This is the monolayer capacity. And the C is the constant. You can also calculate the constant out of this data by using after the plot. So at 75 degree Kelvin, the pressure P naught is the 76.0 kilopascal, and the weight of the adsorbent is 1. Again, when you are getting the or when you are calculating the surface area, it will directly give you the VT surface area, because when you divide one with the surface area, it will give you the same value. And this is the actually the equation is given in the reference where I am getting this data. And as earlier said, there is no difference between this equation to this equation, and just here they have replaced the P over P naught with the Z. So this is just the replacement of the equation over here. And you can go to the detail in our previous lecture or the presentation where I have already given the detail and correlated all of these different equations. So important over here is, first you have to actually to calculate the Z, P over P naught, because here you have to calculate the X, and X is P over P naught, and this is the Y, and first P naught minus P, and then multiply by V, then you have to divide with the P, and P, V, and P naught, all are the values are given over here. So you are just multiplying, dividing, and subtracting, and getting the what are the final values. And here, these are calculated over here. So I suggest to calculate by yourself and compare with these values. So this is the pressure, this is the P over P naught, and this is all about the y-axis is calculated over here. So again, remember, there is no need to change the units over here, because whatever the unit of the V is, the data is given, you will be getting the VM in the same unit. So later on, you can do the conversion when you calculate the surface area or the specific surface area. And here, there is no need to change the unit, even to change the unit of the pressure, because P over P naught, they are the same unit. And this you must have to remember, this is the pressure and P naught should be in the same unit. So when you take the same unit, these are canceled out. There is, again, these are canceled out, only V is left, and that would be the same unit which you are getting over here. If it is millimeter cube, it will be millimeter cube in the monolayer capacity. So again, now you have to plot the data. This is the y-axis, this is the x-axis. As I explained earlier, you will be getting a straight line with the positive slope. And with this, you can get the intercept is very small, as it is indicated over here, 3.98 x minus 6. And the slope is also given over here. And from the slope and the intercept, even you just sum up the slope and the intercept and divide by one, you will get directly the value of the VM. And here there is a small conversion are given over here. And if you have a look, the value of actually the intercept is 0.0398, or you can say 3.98 exponent minus 2. And if you have a look over here, this exponent, actually it may be the minus 4 is taken as a common, and then you have to multiply this factor with this one, because this is not included in the graph, and this is the easiest way to calculate or to plot a graph by taking the common factor out of all these figures. Because if you plot with these everyone, then there is the very small values would be there, and you are not getting too much clear line or the difference between all these points. So it's better to take common exponent minus 4 over here, exponent 3 over here. So exponent minus 4, when you multiply with exponent minus 2, it will become exponent minus 6. In a similar way, this is the slope of the graph, 1.23 exponent minus 3. And there are two common slope is the change in dy over dx. So dy is exponent minus 4 and dx is the exponent 3. So that's why you are multiplying the whole common you have taken at the x-axis and the y-axis, and this will give you directly the value of the this slope. And then you just sum up all these and get the value of the Vm. So this is the way you are getting the VM, and then the your target is to calculate the value of the surface area and the specific surface area or the BT surface area. And this I have already explained to you. Some values are given over here, so you can calculate by using the way I have explained earlier. And one is left, that is the constant. This is the BET constant or the absorption constant over here. So when you, there are the different way to calculate the value of the constant. So by using this formula, you have already done the calculation, the VM, and this is given, and you can get the value of C after putting the value of the VM over here. And then the surface area and the specific surface area I have already explained to you. So you must do it at home to calculate this one. And this is the second exercise. The data is given over here, the same data, but the adsorbent is taken as the silica gel. And this is taken as 0.85 gram. And now see the difference. The VM you are getting out of this, it will be only having the unit of the centimeter cube. And then you, if you want to calculate the specific surface area or the BT surface area, then you have to divide with the 0.85. That will just directly convert the surface area into the specific surface area. So this is the same way you can calculate the values. And I have just done with the slope and the intercept, and I have calculated the VM from here, and the rest of the data is given over here. A is given, S is given, V is given, and then you just first calculate the surface area by using this formula, and then you have to divide by 0.85 with the surface area. You will get the BET surface area or the specific surface area. So with this is all about our today lecture.